and singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were all waiting for this moment to rise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all of your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Thank you. Right about the time when I wrote that song, we were starting to see lots of stuff on the news coming from America about civil rights in places like Alabama and Arkansas. And we couldn't believe it. You know, we couldn't believe the kind of segregation and the bigotry that was going on. We thought America was better than that. And it is. Anyway, I wanted to try and write a song that if it ever got back to the people going through those struggles in Little Rock, it might just give them a little bit of hope. We did get back actually to Little Rock a few years ago, and on the newsroom we'd seen two young black girls going into the school, and the mob was like, yeah, you know, doing all the bit. And we met those, who they were now old ladies, we met those two girls. It was very cool. Okay. So, way back in the beginning of the group, the Beatles, you couldn't really say to each other, hey, I love you, man. It was kind of, it just wasn't a dumb thing, you know. People didn't do that, guys didn't do that to each other. So you'd be kind of, you know, all right, I love you too, mate. But you couldn't do that then, you know, so. So it meant that we went through a lot of stuff just trying to act tough, you know, Anyway, I wrote this next song after John died. Let's hear it for John.